drink it.
Too hot or just nasty?
Nasty. Not hot. Nasty. It was hot.
I don't know why my old phone is suddenly complaining about Sprint Hub closing. Play well. That's all that matters at this point, right?
Yeah, three DMPs. Same result.
Only had one DMP.
I had O'Hagan locked out and DMP. Locked out and I lost. That broke my heart.
I lost three games yesterday to doubles on the last roll.
I like these checkers as well. I think they're really pleasant.
I don't play on this board very often, but I'll try to take it at least one tournament a year or two.
Beautiful board.
Let's see, I guess if I do that, I must be down 10 pips in the trace. I'll take it.
Your feedback already?
Well, I'm doing my own. Oh. I did put on this morning. Okay. So that's actually better than my current average.
Listen, being in the six is like, I know maybe for you it's a pain, but it's exceptionally well. You know.
Yeah, my average is right around 7 right now, so yeah. Like, I'm not complaining about it. It's just mediocre. And that six, anything in sixes and sevens, I'm like, yeah, okay.
I wish still
that,
put you in the
I wish I could do better.
It put you in the top 60% in open, at least.
Yeah, right now I'm at 7, and I'm pretty much exactly in the middle of any open field you ever put together. right in the center of it.
Yeah, that's what I'm measuring. I've been playing close to a 7. Lately, we'll see. I don't know how I did in this tournament.
I think my last 300 on the BMAB is like 7.1.
That's very good, John.
Well, in my last tournament, it knocked off a good tournament. It was just like way down. So I'm trying to get an N2, which means I have to get below 5.5, which I'm way away from that.
To do, I buy it. I have uncomfortable work to do. It's like World War III in that coffee thing. Oh, makes me clear, yeah.
Thank you.
everything they did was quality. Everything I touched, solid.
In terms of tournament play, this is the fourth major board I've got.
Zavrol makes an incredible board.
I like the Zavrol boards because, you know, with the Baffa boxes being more prevalent, with the Zavrol, you've got room to put clock, cube, and Baffa box all just in normal places.
Yeah, it's a wider board.
It's got like a double channel for the game. And the clocking on the back channel, and there's a spot for the cube in front of it.
Yeah, which is nice.
It's not any other boards that do that. Okay, I think I can safely give up now without risking an error. 0-2. Oh, I think
four sheets out.
Beautiful. He doesn't like these boards. This is a beautiful board.
Yeah, I know. I know he doesn't like
them. I love this board.
You want a score sheet?
Nah, I'm just going to let you do it if you want.
I'd absolutely do it.
Do you keep all your score sheets?
I keep them because when I'm transcribing, it's sometimes hard to know.
Oh, I see.
Whether the game's game with a double pass or whatever, right? Back and fast forward through the cube decision because I already know what it is, right? So I keep them for that.
So I have a question. So do you?
But then I toss them after I've done my transcription. I don't get too close.
How good are you with the transcription now?
I'm good at it. The two I did this morning, I ran the video at 3x, and I kept that most of the time. I've just done thousands of matches. I've been recording matches since, I've been going around almost 25 years. When I started recording matches, I was doing them on Super 8 cassettes.
So that's a good, you have good habits for backgammon.
Well, if I actually studied the matches that I recorded, they'd be even better habits.
Right.
Well, that most, right. Lately, I've mostly been using my recordings just as a monitoring system. I'll look at some of them, but I don't do anything systemic with making sure I go through all my matches. It's really just keeping track of how well I'm playing. So many choices.
Doesn't hurt.
A little bit.
Yeah, it depends on where.
Just depends on which color you're playing.
Yeah.
Oh, wow, another one. so many choices. These are the kind of plays that just kill your PR because there's so many ways to fuck that up.
It's true.
I'm playing a hacking game.
Covers.
Thank you.
Interesting. 1, 2.
Still need double sixes.
Yeah.
Because I've got two balls to get those three checkers off.
That's just really scary helpful. Because it's like, by the way I look at it, I have 30% chance of hitting you, and you have 17% chances of coming out. And double. Well, not even, because you need threes and higher.
Yeah. If I roll a one or a two, you've got.
Of course.
Here's the thing. If I roll a one or a two and you miss, you're rolling a higher than average number and you're getting out.
Yeah.
So it doesn't. Your small numbers are good for hitting and your big numbers are good for saving. Yesterday I had four checkers and he had one back, right? And he was on the other side. And he rolled a 3-2. And I'm pretty sure with four he's supposed to just run with a 3-2, but he played it inside over here. I took two checkers off. He rolled another 3-2. And he stayed again, which is not as bad with two checkers as it is before, but I didn't roll the ace, and that was a BG. So
the question was, maybe I shouldn't have taken with so many back, but it was an open board.
I'd be amazed if that wasn't a take.
Yeah, I thought it was a take. Well, that was interesting.
I think I butchered that.
Very complicated.
I think, for example, I was probably supposed to keep the bar point blocked instead of making the 2-point, just leave the block there on the 2-point.
Yeah, I saw you were looking at that for a long time.
Better
containment.
Well, actually, if I keep the bar point, you didn't have any good sixes. Your only sixes would go into the 2-point.
Right, and you don't care.
So I shouldn't have given you, I shouldn't have. I'm less worried about being hit.
That's a good point.
Other place too that I thought were probably bad. We'll see.
Sometimes what you think is a horrible mistake or a blunder turns out to be okay. My ability is to guess what numbers you're going to roll and make sure I'm ready for it. Put myself right there in the train tracks. Okay. Alright, let's do this. Well, let's just move on.
Thank you.
I'm not sure how soon.
Well, you look at a different age, like, well, almost all of his ages are good over there, except for 5-1. Every other ace makes something. Well, except 2-1, I guess, wasn't that great. But.
Thank you. 3.
Flashed the 3, then it flipped over to the 2.
See anything I like more.
Looks great to me.
Thank you.
bad blue one would be for me.
It would be my best, I think. Whereas Greg had, I'll say, it would not be in my bottom 35.
I had a situation with John O'Hagan where he's like, I'm going to put the one over here. I need a 1 and a 6 to hit him. Yeah. And I did. We both looked at each other like, holy shit.
In my playing career, I've had 2 games where I had that last trick and bring out like you do and get past this.
Yeah.
I rolled double ones, got missed. I rolled double ones again and got hit. And this happened to me twice.
It's crazy. So I'm going to cover and give myself just a little bit of risk.
Decision at the end by saving the backgammon.
For real?
Yeah. If you leave that guy back there until he has less than 4 checkers or fewer, yeah, and then bring him out, it's 1 extra decision. See, none of my... A lot of these... When the gammon is guaranteed, the decision doesn't count as a decision. But if there's a possible backgammon, then it does count as a decision. Stupid.
That's sneaky shit.
Stupid PR tricks.
I need to be sure.
But
someone
the thing is, on that, bringing that 2 out is the right play, and it might be a bigger error than I say by getting the extra decision. So you have to be careful with that kind of stupid stuff.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Because you know, I don't get a reach to pit.
I might have gotten penalized for being too conservative. Let's see. Wow. Getting some breaks.
Situation where I can't afford to waste any pips. Oh, 1, 2, I'm going to waste a pip now. And then this guy here. Now I'm favored to save it. Anybody's guess.
Oh.
Now I'm not favored to save it.
Wow.
Now I need double 3s or, oh, actually double 4s are better. I don't have a check on the table. I don't mind throwing that 3 away.
Oh, that's crazy. All right. That's unexpected. All right, give me a 7.
I had some really improbable games this weekend.
It's, you know, some of those gamish positions, it's so hard to hold off of taking them, but...
I've gotten gamish positions that were really not gamish at all.
Right. That's happened to me on my takes, too. Well, I'll find out. Yeah, I'll find out. That's the right play.
Right. I'm about to get into it.
I'm going to get this guy out of dodge.
I Rangers scored.
5-1, 2-1?
Yeah. So you actually have a lower take point than the money at the score, even though you're leading. You take points like just under 20%. So where I might double this. I'm not quite gonna double because I think it's a. See, if you don't know that, then I might.
No, I know that it's a very. I could take high. I mean, meaning I could take deep.
Yeah. Okay. So that's unusual for the leader to have that much lower take point. That's what I'm saying.
Only because you're outside of the gamma range. And it
has more to do with just 2 points winning the match exactly, and Gammon's not winning the match for me.
Yeah, for your point.
So it's kind of a combination of those.
All right. I might need to hold my sixes. I might do this.
If it's an error, it's only an error once, and it's in the queue, right?
That's the part that it's hard to understand.
Yeah, because, well, see, now that's one of the ones that doesn't cover it. That one's not in my top 35.
Oh, yeah. Thank you.
didn't work.
Oh, sorry, sorry.
I'm supposed to put a three here.
The favor.
Yeah, blotted that up.
Fucking game.
It's a stupid game. I don't know why anybody plays this game. Well, I definitely don't want to. I definitely want to have a chance of not moving if you do come in. Maybe I should just give you the six, though. But I should probably just give you the six.
Such an incredible sequence, actually. Like, it could really, you turned that game around completely.
Well, okay, any given sequence of dice is an incredible sequence. The odds against that specific sequence happening are just astronomical.
Right.
Even if they just seem like just mediocre dice.
Right.
It's just
sure.
The context that makes
the
it.
The context makes it incredible. And so, backgammon is so goddamn dramatic.
Thank you.
strong.
Sometimes I try to clear the work on there, and sometimes it's not. I don't have any rules I can rely on to know when it's when. Kind of guess. I'm going really well though. I've still got my 4-point board. Chances of that were pretty slim.
For a minute there's like a sequence of 5-6 rolls where nothing moved. Say if anyone can, it would be against me. I tend to I was carefully looking how many guys I have out.
Oh yeah, so you're still a prisoner. Yeah. You need more help than just what you've done so far. In this case, I don't like that one.
11-10 is
for you.
Oh. I'm out of shape I never before this. What's your record now, Bob? 1-3. Oh, 1-3.
Me too.
Don't be wrong about this.
You're still outperforming me, though.
No, well, it went. We both got gammons in.
I don't have a good feeling about my PR on this field this match. I don't think it was very good.
I never know, honestly.
I'm never sure. Sometimes I think I played really well and I go up a double digit or something. Sometimes I think I played really badly and it's okay. I rarely think I played really badly and it's good. But sometimes I think I played really badly.